believe me and when I said that there's a stand in part 5 that's a fishing rod and it can fuck your shit?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. I have seen half of part 3 and I'll believe balsically anything at this point.
All right, balsically?
Balsically. Yeah.
Oh, you had your pants stretched.
Yeah, I got my pants stretched. Yeah,
That's the man thing.
That was a strategic crotch slap.
Welcome back.
Unlike the non-strategic crotch slaps I frequently do.
Now, these... Well, Link's dead. Adventure over. Return of Ganon.
Bye. Whatever that probably destroys our shield. Or not.
Oh, okay, so lava does not destroy the shield.
Okay, but fire keys will fuck it up.
Yes. Well, that's fire hitting it, not lava. There's a difference.
Okay. I think you might have a slight misunderstanding of how physics work.
Well, explain then how... fucking Akainu beat Ace. Because he was lava, and Ace was fire.
Okay, first of all, that's a goddamn comic book.
Yes.
So it's already bullshit.
Okay.
And secondly, because lava is...
Fuck that door!
Because lava is even hotter.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
So it would burn... It probably wouldn't even bother burning it. It would just vaporize it.
Mm.
Tick-tock.
Tick-tock on the clock.
I wasn't sure where that was going.
I swear to God, if you had picked up that rock and what's-her-name was under it, I'd be like, oh god, no!
Yeah, that would have been a little terrifying.
We see her in a pot, we just go the other way.
Yeah, I don't want to deal with that. Then she's gonna, like, introduce herself later in the game, and it's like, no.
No.
I bet that's what those, like, spots on the, I bet that's like what this is.
Probably. It seems like one of those items that's not connected to anything. Same thing for the other item. Yeah. What the fuck is that?
That is...
Is that like a fire Zora? Because it seems like it had the exact same attack style like Zoras from previous games.
Kind of. According to like official sources, that is basically this game's equivalent of an Octorok, except on fire.
I was going to say Octorok next, yeah.
Yeah, because this game, again, like, this game doesn't have Octoroks. It just has this weird fish enemy that appears in a couple places.
Fair enough.
And this is one of them.
Oh!
Damn it!
It's move the control stick up.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. It's kind of an annoying thing because you see the button prompt, and you're like, oh, I better press this button to pull myself up. Nope, that's the button prompt to let go. Let go, Link. Let them all go.
It's time to stop fighting for others. It's time to achieve your own dream.
Go.
Fuck!
Wow, that... Don't go that way.
Yeah, I'm not going that way anymore.
That jump is terrible. You know, looking up stuff on this game, like researching it for pictures and all that shit, a lot of people really like this game.
Oh, yeah, no, this game, like... Well, see, right when it released, like, because building up to it, people thought it was going to be, like... The Zelda game they always wanted.
Oof. Yeah.
Like, it's because the movement's so smooth in this game.
No, it does actually, it does move, like, movement-wise, like, how it's presented is actually very nice.
Yeah.
It's got good presentation. You can say that much about most Legend of Zelda games that are, like, the console ones especially, they have pretty good presentation.
Yeah, I mean, look what Majora's Mask did with the N64, holy shit.
Oh!
That was...
Can't have that shield burn, bruh.
No, it's the Orton shield. There's only one in the game.
Oh, no. Because, yeah, what do we get instead? It's just a crap wooden shield?
Yeah.
It's just called wooden shield?
Yes.
Ah.
What the fuck was this for?
You have to go
was
up somewhere.
Literally?
No, there it is. Okay. Jump over and then jump over.
That's been a while.
Maybe we should have practiced a bit before starting this. Oh, shit. Oh, no, that's just a slug.
Yeah.
Just a slug.
Just like the lava slugs from the Fire Temple in Ocarina.
Oh, yeah. You know, what's funny is... I actually forget... Well, it's probably because I haven't played it much. But I actually, like, just forget so many dungeons
in
Ocarina.
I'm not gonna...
What?
I'm not gonna risk that.
Oh yeah, since you got hit by the enemy.
Yeah, and it's timed. So
yeah.
Yeah. See there, it's gone.
Ah. Yeah, I actually don't remember any of the dungeons or Ocarina, but I feel like if I were to play the game again and actually, like, play the dungeons, I'd immediately remember all of them.
Probably, yeah.
That's what I feel about a lot of, like, Legend of Zelda, is like, oh man, oh, I don't remember this dungeon at all. But now, when you play it, you're like, you just, it all just comes back to you. Other than a Zelda that you play a lot, like, for me, that's Majora.
Yeah, that one you're not likely to forget.
No, I don't forget that one, because there's a lot to remember in that game. There's a hell of a lot to remember. Whoa. Boop. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool symbol.
Oh, the Goron symbol?
Yeah. I like the Goron symbol in this.
Well, that was what it was. That's what it's always been.
Really?
Yeah, because that's the shape the Goron Ruby was in Ocarina.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, now everything's coming back to me. The magnets.
Mm-hmm. This right. is the magnetic place.
This is weird to see in Zelda.
Yeah.
Like, it's like this game itself is just more, like... This game just feels more like...
Oh, wrong button.
What do you want? Get out of here, pointy feet. She has no feet.
Nope.
But, yeah, this game just... There's a lot in this game that's, like, very mechanical.
Yeah.
Like, there's just so many things that are, like... It's like, okay, so this is fantasy, right? Then why are there, like, cranes and gears and, like, other such things? But you're still riding horses everywhere and getting all your mail delivered by one man.
Yeah, this area really reminds me of the friggin', what do you call it? The Magmoor Depths in Metroid Prime more than a
yeah,
Zelda game.
Yeah, seriously.
But,
I don't know what you're talking about, but I agree.
you've seen me go through it.
Where's the remote?
It's next to the mic.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, the lava level in Prime?
Yeah.
Yeah. I know, I see what you're saying.
But,
this whole area just feels, like, very not Zelda-y.
Yeah.
But it's still, like, oh, it's like, not too futuristic.
Yeah, it's just a little more mechanical than they usually go.
Well, it is a mine, but it seems just weird. Oh, shit. Dodongo? Or Salamander?
I'm willing to call it a mini Dodongo, at least.
Oh! Gotta save that shield, bro.
Yep, that's my goal here.
Yeah, fuck you.
But yeah, friggin', I usually appreciate it, though, when, like, fantasy... diverges from that.
Well, Final Fantasy is all about that.
Oh yeah, that's what Final Fantasy does.
Final Fantasy is like, hey, let's be fantasy, except bridge like have just this line drawn between like having mechanical stuff and like flying airships, but then also like medieval stuff. Mm. It's really weird like that. Some of them do it better than others. I would say Final Fantasy VII. Final Fantasy VII is such a big metaphor.
Yeah.
For, like, environment.
Yeah, so they actually do it pretty well, because you have the big technological areas, and that's where all the bad shit is.
Yeah, but then the rest of the world just feels very poor, and you're like, so it's just this one part of the world that's like this, and the rest of the world is just kind of like, meh? I don't know, I never got what the rest of the world was with VII. I felt like I was missing some context. Because the rest of the world looks like shit. Like, everyone else is just poor and living in the shit, and they all use, like, materia, and they're all powered by, like, mana. And it just seems very strange. Like, you're just missing some... Oh.
Yeah.
Oh!
Yeah!
Yeah, very much.
But yeah, friggin'...
What was another one that... Oh, well, 8 kind of does that.
8 kind of does that. 8 really does go more for the technological, but not with 7's technology is bad thing.
Yeah, technology is bad. It's more so, like, people
are just...
Well, you start the entire thing... You start it in, like, a floating school.
Yeah.
So...
Yeah, I think,
Whoa!
I forgot that was so fast.
Yeah, they might have sped that up, actually. That's honestly pretty pretty sweet.
Super cool. I actually, like, I think the gravity, magnetism mechanic in this really works well.
Oh, yeah. No, it's actually pretty sweet.
Yeah, I think.
Oh, what the fuck? What are you looking at?
Fucking onion. Alright, present for the young human, Gogoron, the mortal, Gogorobatabo! Yeah, there's three other Goron elders in here who.
Oh, and you have to.
Pieces of the boss key.
Don't you have to, like, sumo them?
No, they're fucking tiny.
Oh, they are?
Yeah.
I thought you had to sumo them. Huh. Why is he in a sumo ring then?
Because that's just where Gorons stand.
Honestly, that map actually looks pretty solid.
Yeah.
Like, it's like leather and nice and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Again, presentation wise, this game looks great.
Oh, fantastic.
It's just everything else that seems just kind of like. Here's an entire cast of characters. Are they interesting? Not really. When will you see them? Once. Oh.
Yeah. All right.
Okay.
I can't even swing my sword in here.
Oh. It's just straight, you can't fight.
Yeah, this is just a house.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, it's a house in the mine.
That's kind of neat.
Yeah.
I like that.
I actually like this dungeon. It's pretty cool. Simple, but effective.
Yeah, I find it funny that a lot of people, when thinking about... Oh. No!
What?
Yeah, you walked by it and it moved, and I was like...
I didn't even notice.
I was like, is that a spider? Oh, no, no.
Get the fuck out of here.
We don't need no Ferroar's wind in here.
Oh, wait, well, I think the boomerang will work on the... Or does it just put them out?
It might just put them out. Yeah. Yep.
Damn it. Let's see if this is more or something.
Wouldn't be surprised, honestly. Oh.
Yeah, see, here's the thing about the slingshot. It's worthless. Well, it's not like they can move really fast.
Nah, but you can't either. But, yeah, Majora, I love how a lot of people just, like, love the... Can you slice it on this? Oh, you can.
Oh, so I can.
Oh, okay, never mind.
I forgot I could do that.
Wall combat, bruh. But, whoop! Yeah, Majora. People really like the time mechanic and just like learning about people and just like the Bomber's Notebook and all that. Like, everyone praises that like so hard, and I love that too. But actually, like, I'm like one of those sides of people that likes the dungeons, but then there are the people who, you know, like, don't like the dungeons because on the dungeons, one, you have a time limit.
Yeah.
Two, you have to. The dungeons are all kind of like maze-like.
Yeah, and they're all built with the possible exception of Stone Tower, they're all built with the same basic sort of
like
design.
You have to explore everywhere. Areas link to each other. You got to go back to areas.
Yeah,
and
a lot of backtracking.
And I totally get what people say about that game. It's like the dungeons. Like, some people like really like the game, but find the dungeons incredibly tedious.
Yeah,
and I can see what they're going.
Honestly. Yeah, Majora's Mask doesn't have the best dungeons.
Yeah,
definitely
Great
not.
Bay. Like, people hate okay. Great Bay.
Fuck Great Bay.
People hate Great... Yeah, exactly. People hate Great Bay more than they hate the Water Temple. The Water Temple is like, yeah, if you miss one key, you're going to just have a mess of a time. And I agree with you. That one key is not wrong. But that's just one tiny thing. All of Great Bay is annoying. Hell, since they... What did they increase the timer in fucking... In the 3DS, Majora's Mask goes faster, which makes Great Bay even harder.
Yeah.
Didn't you, like, game over going through there?
Yes, I did.
Like, you got to the boss and just game over because you took too long.
Yes, I had...
Because they added more stuff to that boss, which made the boss battle go on longer.
Yes, I had great difficulty in that in the 3DS version as well. And this is after me playing this game for, like, 10 years.
Yeah, so we already knew everything, but it's just The timer was increased, like, I didn't have too much problem, but yeah, I could feel that, like, since they, like, lowered, or they sped up the timer in Majora, that made a lot of those dungeons harder, because you had to, like, you had to play it on double time. Like, even on double time, it was still hard. It was like, what the fuck? Which was kind of annoying that they did that.
This place really reminds me of Magmore.
Yeah. Oh, now I know what you're talking about. Yeah. Yeah, no, I... Oh, jeez. I see what. Yeah, no, I know. I get what you're talking about now. Because there's this one, like, this one big facility part where
you're in the middle of the lava.
In the middle of lava, yeah.
Yeah, you've probably seen me go through there a lot because it's really annoying to get up because you have those little drones and shit.
No, I remember what you're talking about now.
Oh, shit. There's the fire keys.
Oh, they're dead.
Spin attack.
You killed, like, three at the same time. It would suck if you, like, left this temple and just one goblin just shoots your,
shoots your shield with a
fire arrow, just gone. Damn it! Whoop. But, everything with, like, what's up? Everything with, like, the schedule and, like, all that stuff in Majora is fucking fantastic.
Oh, it's awesome.
And every character just feels good. I think it's... See, what's weird is a lot of characters, opposite to their Ocarina of Time characters, aren't that... Like, well, there's some that are just better.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what's her name? Oh, Water Striders.
I did it.
Oh, no.
You got it? You got this one?
No, sorry, I can't remember.
Tektite.
Right. They've been in since the first game.
Yes, they have.
Oh, man, you fuck them up. Jeez.
Yeah.
You, like, chopped off their limb and shit. Damn. Damn, Link.
Yeah, Link doesn't take prisoners.
Can you actually grab that right now? Or?
Yeah, sure.
Oh. Thought you would need the, just holding his breath super hard right now.
It's not that hard.
Keep your mouth closed.
There we go.
But,
dripping.
I like that little detail.
It's a good detail.
Yes.
Well, that's something I have to come out of later, I think.
Yeah, when you lower the water level.
Unless...
Do you have to shoot that?
Probably.
Can you shoot with a bow? Or with a... with that?
I guess not.
The boomerang actually doesn't make any physical damage.
Unfortunately. Oh. You just can't affect it with anything but the bow.
Oh. So, I guess we're not supposed to be here right now.
Or?
Oh, okay.
I am supposed to go this way. Oh, yeah, I can just walk past this.
Fair enough.
But yeah, oh, popping back on the friggin' technology in fantasy thing.
Mm-hmm.
There's one thing I wanted to mention. I read this,
Whoa!
I love doing that in midair. I read this, this graphic novel by, Kazu Kibuishi.
The Amulet?
Yes, yeah. Amulet. It's, super fucking cool. Really good, really good series. Only puts out a book a year. Yeah, it takes forever, and I feel
it's
like...
it's relatively long, isn't it?
Yeah, and the art is, oh my god, fantastic. Like, he draws it all out, and then his wife fucking paints it. But, it's awesome. I can't really like this dungeon. But, yeah, and it's like, it starts off, like, these kids end up in what looks like this fantasy world with weird creatures, and there's these creepy elves and whatnot, and it's like, oh, okay, so they're just in some fantasy world, and then you catch sight of, like, what's basically a mech, and it's like, oh, well... Okay, I guess they can make, like, big constructs like that. But, like, just don't go into it thinking it's another generic fantasy thing, because then you realize that they've actually got better technology than Earth, and then they've got fucking, like, the most recent volume that came out as of this recording, friggin' Book 7, they're going to space. Because they just have that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah, it is about as far from a friggin' fantasy thing as you can get.
Mm.
There's magic. But guess what? The magic... You know, I'm not gonna spoil
it,
but...
So it's Thor. It's essentially Thor.
Yeah, it's like Thor, except less old-timey.
Yeah.
It's like the rustic design of most of the houses is the closest to an old-timey fantasy story you're gonna get.
I see.
It, like, tricks you with its aesthetic,
mm.
But it's really a sci-fi story.
Nice.
There just so happens to be a bit of magic in it, though. So.
Chape.
But yeah, if anyone's interested in reading that, it's super goddamn cool.
Oh, I know that's... I know that series is pretty, loyal fan base.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just one of those things that, like, garnered a bit of a... Oh, there's a... It garnered a niche really, really easily.
Yeah.
And it hasn't, like...
What'd that do?
I don't know. Oh, maybe that's a way to open the door from...
Yeah, to go back. Yeah, okay. Go back up the thing. Go to the other side. Because there's a treasure chest. Which might be a stamp, but who knows?
Yeah. They're actually thinking of making a movie out of it. But then again, they've been thinking about making movies out of a lot of things.
Yeah.
But then again, a lot of the things that I've given up for being in development hell forever, some of which I was thankful for them being lost forever, are actually getting made.
Yeah.
It's like, oh.
Hey, oh, yes, that's awesome. Good. That's good. That. I like that. Jurassic Park. Jurassic World. That was, like, the most unnecessary, but... Oh,
yeah.
God, that movie was
That was a lot of fun.
Yeah, it was a fun movie.
Yeah.
Did it make sense? No. Didn't have to.
Yeah, I really didn't have to.
There was a scientist character in that movie that literally said, yeah, do you think dinosaurs look like that? We engineered them to look better. To look cool.
To look like what people expected.
Yeah. And it's like God damn it. That's
you guys just put that in after all the scientists got angry at you, didn't you?
Oh, shit. Dudes with, I'd say just put your weapon away. Or at least chop something down and just face the other direction. Gotta keep that shield.
Not losing the shield. I'm not losing it, man! We can get out of this! Alright, I can hop up on these.
Why?
There's probably a reason. I don't remember if there's anything interesting over here.
Yeah, just a few boxes. Wait, that box looks... Oh, okay. I was gonna say, these boxes look important, like you're supposed to put them on switches or something.
If they're that important, you probably couldn't,
Oh, I need a key. Yeah!
That's a pushing box.
Put away your sword. Oh.
Is this a pushing box? No, it's not.
No, it's not. It's just a...
Just a really standing out metal box.
This area is weird.
Little.
Like, it doesn't make any sense. There's Why are these things so... Like, I'd assume it's because, I'd assume it's because, like, this area's a mine, so it's meant to sort of look like it has, like, homes and stuff in it. Ah, fuck.
Ah, fuck.
What do we get?
We got the letter H.
For fuck!
H is for fuck! B is for fuck! I'm very lonely! Okay, nothing else of interest in this water.
Did we ever find out what, like... No, I'm just sort of dissecting Zelda at this point, but... We can see that he's doing a specific style of... We can't go that way.
Well, maybe I have a key.
No, there's no key above your map.
Oh, touche.
Okay, so that's a specific style of swimming. So, do the other Links all know, like, different styles of swimming?
Perhaps? I'm not sure.
Got a good, like, backstroke Link?
I don't think any of them backstroke.
Can you ever go, like point the opposite direction and swim?
Oh yeah, if you lock onto something, like, if... Yeah, it's,
It's more of, like, a...
Paddling back.
Yeah, it's a paddling backwards. Because, like, I know what he's...
He's obviously treading water here.
Yeah, and then he's... I think that's a specific one.
Yeah, I think so. Like, I actually, like... I took swim lessons for a while, and...
Get up there, Link.
I was pressing up, and he was trying to go down.
I love when the game does that. The game thinks you're gonna press the ult. Like, when you go down in Pokemon, and then you go to a new area, and down equals leaving.
Yeah.
And you go down, and you leave, and
then... Oh, yeah, in the 3D Pokemon games
now? 3D Pokemon games, and it's like, no, idiot, you were supposed to press up after pressing down. Like, fuck you, I didn't know that. This is pretty sweet.
Yeah, when I think of dungeons in this game, this is one of the ones I think of most fondly.
Ooh.
Yeah. I'm fucking pro with this shit. I know I haven't been doing a very good job proving it so far, but... Ah, for a young human, ah, let me eat you. I'm very hungry. Take this, brother.
Are they all male?
Yes.
Isn't there a female one?
I think there was a female one in the friggin', in one of the mangas.
Oh.
But that's it. I don't think there's ever been a female Goron in a game.
I see.
Like, ever, brudda.
You know what's funny? I've been, looking at other people who were playing the, oh my god. Oh my god. This is the Pokemon Center problem all over again.
Yeah, just on a bike trying to get into the Pokemon Center, just one step away, just fuck. Try to find a gif of that.
But, yeah, I've noticed, like, other people who've been playing the HD collection of this, other people who are just playing the game to play the game, aside from, you know, like, playing the HD, you have to go that way. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, aside from just them playing the HD version of the game, or just playing it first time on their show, they, too, hate Milo.
Mallow from Malamar?
Yeah, Mallow, yeah. They, too, hate Mallow.
Everyone hates Mallow.
Mallow's the worst.
Nobody likes Mallow.
Mallow's the one that, like, furthers money moving through Hyrule.
And who likes a capitalist?
Some people. But yeah, the money system in these games is just... In this game especially is fucked. And Mallow is there to reap the benefits. So what's down here? Just a bunch of...
Tektites and nothing.
Alright, there's probably a hidden chest in there. When we get the comp ass, we'll probably know.
It was, looks, mini-bossy.
Is he gonna lock the door as you, enter?
Yep. I forget what the mini-boss... Oh!
Is it a giant turtle?
Nope. It's actually a Goron.
Oh.
War, human! Forbidden place, protect the treasure!
Okay.
This guy actually gave me a lot of trouble once upon a time.
Oh yeah, because you have to like sumo him like with.
This is where all your sumo skills pay off.
Huh. Interesting.
Eh.
He's gonna get you.
Yeah, you gotta fucking stab him in his gut. Eh.
Because, yeah, this guy could... You're trying to just get him to fall off, right?
You're supposed to, like, hurt him enough? Just stabbing at him when his guard is down?
I see. But he never attacks, huh?
Not a whole lot at this point, but he does get pretty aggressive later in the fight.
I see. Oh, yeah, there he goes.
Alright, yeah, there he finally threw a punch. That's the best time to get him, too. Oh, fuck.
Whoa!
Damn it.
Oh, that sucks. It is pretty sweet to see a Goron fucking, like, wearing metal armor.
War Gorons.
Yeah, I totally said press A there.
Yeah.
But nothing happened.
Come on, come get me. And here, and get into the lava.
Oh, it's like you have to do it multiple times?
Yes.
Of course you do, because yeah. Zelda loves that.
Rule three. Ow. Now he just doesn't. Okay, fuck you. I let go of the button a little too quickly.
Oh, yeah, you have to actually pull it and do it.
Okay, come on. Yeah, there we go. Get. Yeah!
Nice. But it's kind of a weirdly, you have to, like, position
yourself. I think I should,
yourself.
Like, stay with the boots off for the most part.
Yeah.
Oh,
shit.
Oh, fucking fall. Okay, so maybe I should have the boots on. Because I want to have, like, the boots off so I can backflip away, get some distance, and then...
Oh, come on. Really?
Well, he's still down there, so maybe...
Do you have to actually, like, re-hurt him?
I don't know.
Would not be surprised.
Yeah. Let's find out. Okay. And yeah, see that was fuck, I let go of it. That was entirely my fault.
Well, we'll end the episode with you beating this guy. So.
Yeah. Okay.
Get out of here, you! Yeah, looks like you gotta do the whole fight again. Might as well guzzle that red potion.
Oh, yeah, maybe I should. Do-do-do. Tasty.
Give me a second here, buddy. Delicious.
Grabbing. There we go. Yeah, but you still have to make sure your back is close.
Yeah, your back is
to
close
the...
to the edge.
Yeah.
So
okay.
The prompt appears, but you have to actually press it like awkwardly in a number of situations.
Okay. Positioning myself like this should be good.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, this guy really isn't hard.
He's not that hard. Get out of here, you!
Damn it!
Come on.
Okay, let's try this angle.
Whoa,
oh,
fuck.
That was... Yeah, that's the time I could have gotten him.
Yeah.
I just don't remember that attack.
Well, it's obviously at the third stage, so... Get out of here!
There we go!
That's what you get, weird, ugly Goron.
Fuck, Pumpkinhead. He looks like that guy from Simpsons. People who look like things. This is the guy whose head is basically a pumpkin. All we ask is that we be treated with respect. And a new candle every now and again. Yes, and a new candle. No! So yeah, now I can claim my prize.
Which is a bow.
Way to spoil it.
Given the dungeon, it kind of makes little sense.
Yeah.
Like, most of the dungeon items in this game make no sense.
Yep, no, like...
It's like hey,
say,
this...
One
this...
of the biggest weaknesses of this game is its dungeon items.
Yeah. Because it's like, hey, this dungeon item, you can use this, like, all over this dungeon. Cool! Can I use it outside the dungeon? No!
This is like the only useful dungeon item in the game.
I think they could have just shrunken it down a bit there, because it looked like it was just gonna like clock Link in the nuts.
It's already a pretty small bow.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
You're fucking... Get him!
Well, that's a good time to end the episode, I say.
Maybe. Ah! It dropped a blue rupee.
A blue poopy?
A rude bloopy. Brr! Who else?
Where did that even come
Give me
from?
A fucking reason!
So we just entered the Goron mine, right? The fire temple?
Yes.
The fur temple?
Fur temple. We're gonna have to fight our way through hordes of furries.
I saw that going a different direction of fur trappers.
I see.
It's fur dungeon. They're all just wearing fur.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, yes. Yes, this was made from a skunk.
Either way, I'm going to have to get through an extra layer.
It's another extra layer for my shotgun to go through.
Fucking wish I had a shotgun. I just got a sword.